Hi, I'm Orman Beckles, aka the Hi Tech Nomad. This channel is for people who want easy to understand videos on the basics as well as tips and tricks for cell phones, apps, computers, smart home devices, and more. So if you want to learn how to make technology work for you, then start now by pushing the subscribe button and be sure to click the bell icon so you don't miss a video. In part 4 of our series on using the camera for the Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra, we're going to take a look at video. I'm going to show you some examples, and in order for you to literally see what I'm talking about, we are first going to make sure that your phone is set correctly for viewing this particular video. So I'm going to ask our resident overdub voice, Henry, to walk you through just doing that. Henry?
To get the most out of this video, I suggest that you watch this on your Samsung Galaxy Note 20 or Note 20 Ultra. You don't have to, but I'm going to proceed as if you are. Next, if you haven't already, please turn your phone horizontally. There, let's get started. Let's check your current quality setting. You can follow along with me, it won't stop the video. Tap somewhere on your screen and the overlay will appear. Tap the three vertical dots in the upper right corner of your screen. Then click Quality. You'll see some various video quality options. More than likely you don't see as many options as I have. If you're not seeing all these options, there are a couple of things we need to change. The first is Wi-Fi. You need to be on Wi-Fi because most mobile data plans in the United States now limit the maximum quality at which you can stream video. They pulled this little switcheroo a few years ago. To this day they tell you that you have unlimited data but they limit your video quality. Why did they do this? The money, of course. The higher the video quality, the more data is needed to deliver it to your phone. As more and more people started watching more and more streaming services like Netflix, the mobile networks started to feel the strain. The mobile companies came up with an idea. They decided to lower the video quality and limit the maximum video quality available to you, thus reducing the total data needed to support its customers. Since you can't see the difference unless it's shown to you side by side, as I will in a moment, they got away with it. But boys and girls, they didn't stop there. They started offering customers special data plans for more money to get the same video quality that they were giving them before. Orman, can you show us a couple of examples?
These are the real prices at the time of this video. You'll notice for AT&T, if I give them $30, I can get standard definition, which is probably 720. But if I'm willing to give them $15 more, then I can get HD streaming, which is probably 1080. T-Mobile does the same thing. As you can see, it's standard, and then HD. And Verizon is actually the worst of all. I can get as low as 480. But if I give them more money, I can either get 720, or if I pay the most, I can get 4K.
That's right, they sold you a phone capable of high quality video, and then made it so you can't use that high quality on their network. Unless, of course, you agree to give them even more money. Bravo. So unless you have a top tier plan, which is code for a more expensive plan, your video quality options will be limited. Switching to Wi-Fi resolves this issue. The second issue we need to address is your phone's display resolution. Please don't change this now as it will stop this video. Let me explain the setting and then I'll give you an opportunity to change it. If your phone display is set to HD Plus or 1544x720, then the highest you'll be offered is 720. If your phone display set for FHD Plus or 2316x1080, then the highest you'll be offered will be 1080. And if your display is set to WQHD Plus or 3088x1440, then you'll be able to choose 1440. You can change your display resolution by going into your apps, find and click the settings icon, then click display. Scroll down till you see screen resolution and tap it. Then click WQHD Plus or 3088x1440. You must restart the phone for the changes to take effect. I've added a chapter mark into the comments so after your phone reboots you can rejoin this video at this exact point. Please make those changes now. I'll wait.
Welcome back. So go ahead and click down below and double check because I want to make sure that you're on the 1440. You'll see a little P and a 60. We're going to talk about what that 60 means in a second. But that's what you should be seeing right now because I'm going to show you some examples. So hopefully you have the settings set right. Go down again and check it just to make absolutely sure. You should be on the highest possible setting. And you may have noticed a P and a 60 after that. And that has to do with frames per second. And that's what we're going to talk about right now. So it says 60 frames a second, but through the magic of editing, I'm actually showing you this right now. What you're looking at is in 30 frames a second. I want you to keep an eye on that fan above me. So in 30 frames per second, it has what we call motion blur. So it gives it a dreamlike cinematic effect. And that's great if you're trying to achieve that particular effect. If you want to have a more realistic effect, if you want people to feel more like they're there, then I suggest shooting in 60 frames a second. And I'm going to let you see what that looks like right now. And this is 60 frames a second. Again, take a look at that fan up there. So you get much less, you still have a little bit, but you get much less motion blur in the 60 frames a second as you did in the 30 frames a second. Some people love this, some people hate it. Some new movies that they're shooting, they shoot in 60 frames a second, and people feel like it has too much of a camcordy video feel. I actually happen to like it for things, especially things that are fast moving. If I was doing a sporting event, I want to have this. I don't want to have that motion blur. So now we have to talk about what resolution. So from what you just saw, you realize that a lot of people are probably going to look at your video in 720 or 1080. That's because they don't know how to set it like you've now set it. So here we are with 720. Let's go ahead and switch to 1080. So here we are with 1080. Again, I finally left the studio just so that you could see some things in the background. I wanted you to see movement, and I wanted you to see things in the background like the trees and leaves. So this is the 1080. So for the most part, you're probably going to shoot in 1080. This is the UHD Plus. And again, you can see that every level we go up, it gets sharper and sharper, and we get a little bit more definition of the colors in the background. But we're also still shooting with 30 frames per second. So let's go back and take a look at 1080 at 60 frames a second. So this is the 1080 at 60 frames a second, and I think you can see why I like to shoot in 60 frames a second. I think it gives a more of a feel that the person is actually there. But let's go up to the UHD Plus at 60 frames a second. And here we are at the best of the best. So here we are at the UHD Plus at 60 frames a second. And you can see why I love that particular look. But again, if you're looking for a more cinematic look, you're going to want to drop it down to the 30 frames a second. Of course, you can always shoot at this higher level and do your export as a 1080 or a 720, and a lot of people say to do that. However, a lot of the different editing programs won't support this higher level and at this many frames per second. So you want to, one, keep in mind who's going to be looking at it, and two, what tools you're gonna use. For a lot of you, you're shooting things for YouTube, so you might as well do 1080 at 30 or 60 frames a second. So aside from the regular video mode, we have a pro video mode. And the pro video mode works similarly to the pro photo mode that we had before. This is where we can control everything manually, the focus, the aperture, the exposure. So in this one, start down and work up. And in this one, I'm going to suggest that you start up and work down. And the most important thing in my mind for the pro video mode is this bottom icon. This bottom icon is going to allow you to pick which microphone you use. It's getting a little noisy out here, and I'm going to show you why this is a good feature in a minute. So we have the ability to use the front microphone, the rear microphone, a US microphone, or a Bluetooth microphone. Let me show you how that works. So I'm about 12 feet away from the camera, and we're using the microphone that's directly in the back of the camera. And of course, I've got a lot of noise going on, but I wanted to show you what it would be like if you were trying to film outside using that microphone that I pointed out earlier that's part of the camera housing on the back of the camera.
So again, I'm about 12 feet away from the camera, but this time I'm using my Galaxy Buds Live Bluetooth microphone. So it's using the microphone that would normally be used for me using a phone call. It's using that microphone to send the mic, to send my voice to the camera. Now, technically, any Bluetooth headset should do that, and you should be able to even get a lavalier or handheld Bluetooth microphone, and you should be able to do the same thing.
So now you know the basics of video. Which do you prefer, the 30 frames per second or the 60? Leave a comment below. Now, in the next installment, we're going to take a look at the specialty video modes like live focus, hyperlapse, slow-mo, slow motion, and more. If you've learned something in this video, please thank us by clicking the like button. Until the next time, this is the Hi Tech Nomad signing out.